Hi, good evening. I'm Sean Green with Sports Night. Let's begin with cricket news. St. Kitts and Nevis are through to the final of the 2017 Hero Caribbean Premier League. Last night in the playoff against host Trinidad and Tobago Knight Riders at the Brian Lara Stadium, the Patriots were sent into bat first and they made 149 for 7 off their 20 overs. Skipper Chris Gayle batted through the innings for 54 not out with 3 fours and 3 sixes. He was the player of the match. For the Trinbago skipper Dwayne Bravo, he took 4 for 38. Now the Knight Riders were then dismissed for 111 in 19.3 for the Patriots to win by 38 runs. Pacer Sheldon Cottrell took 3 for 17. We have a match report.
Gayle and Lewis opened the batting as they've done so well all season. And Lewis fell to a fantastic running catch by Dan Christian. One of the highlights of this CPL. But Gayle occasionally, Tom Murray, occasionally blossomed.
He did. You know, he hit some nice shots, but he was well restricted. Hafiz came to the crease and looked like he was going to post a big score. Right from the get-go, he found the middle of the bat, but there's just one too many drives for him that didn't quite find the middle of the bat. The outside edge, the first over from Kevon Cooper, picked up a wicket. First game back for some time. And King came to the crease and played a couple of nice shots. Picked up a couple of boundaries. Gayle still remained there from time to time, found the boundary. But it was always if they were held back. The run rate was never really getting ahead. A couple of chances went missing, but overall the fielding was pretty good for TKR.
Yeah, Bravo went on a short ball attack against Brandon King. He got dropped one ball, hit a six the next ball. Then he was caught by Dinesh Randin, the highest partnership of the innings, a 48 broken. Carlos Brathwaite, a couple of lusty blows from him in tandem with Chris Gayle. The biggest of the night, this six from Gayle, until Bravo found some more magic to remove Brathwaite.
Yeah, Mohammad Nabi came in and it was a brief visit for him. A terrific Yorker from Bravo to finish him off. A little bit of luck for Carter, but one too many leading edges was his demise. Comfortably taken. That was beaten second wicket. And Bravo was good, but on the odd occasion, which happens at the back end of the innings, he got hit for a boundary, but then Searles picked up a brilliant catch to finish off the innings for TKR.
And the run chase. But early on, after three deliveries, we saw Evan Lewis hitting the stumps in the end of Sunil Narine, and then William Perkins caught down the leg side off Hilvenhouse.
Yeah, it was two quick wickets within the power play over, so it put a lot of pressure on this Knight Riders batting lineup. Colin Munro, their most prolific player, had to depart as well. Cotterell getting his first wicket, the first of three. But there was a nice partnership between Dinesh Randin and Darren Bravo. 36. Some lovely strokes both sides of the wicket. Randin in particular was timing the ball nicely before disaster happened.
But it was a good partnership and they were beginning to get their confidence until Randin got a leading edge off Brathwaite and Gayle take the catch. Now then, this was another problem. Darren Bravo stranded halfway down. Lewis again with the throw. And Dan Christian adjudged LBW to Hafiz. He didn't like that.
It was left for Dwayne Bravo, the captain. A big task. The run rate climbed to just about 14 runs over required. Shadab Khan went, caught Chris Gayle. And with a couple hero maximums from the captain, he had no choice but to open his hands. This was another to leg side. And then Jervon Searles attempting his own hero maximum fell. Carlos Brathwaite made no mistake. And Captain Bravo, that was the third wicket for Cotterell. And his traditional salute again. It was too much of a task for the Knight Riders. Gayle bringing himself on and eventually getting the last wicket of Kevon Cooper.
So Patriots go straight into Saturday's final, while the Knight Riders have a second shot on Thursday when they take on the winner of tonight's eliminator between the Jamaica Talawas and the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Now that game starts at 8 p.m. It will be live on CBC TV 8 and Radio 94.7 FM. And there's more cricket first thing tomorrow morning as the Windies chase their first Test series win outside the Caribbean against a team other than Zimbabwe and Bangladesh since 1995. Now, their three Test series against England is tied at 1-1, with the decisive third match starting at 6 a.m. Barbados time from Lords. It will be live on MCTV's Sportsmax 1. Now, the Windies will also have to deal with an understandable distraction as Hurricane Irma, the most powerful Atlantic Ocean hurricane ever recorded, continues to hit parts of the Caribbean.